Here's a quick overview of the OpenTable for Restaurants menu. Tap the menu button on any screen in OpenTable. The floor plan is the default view, showing the reservation and wait lists, as well as table layouts for the selected shift. You will also see quick buttons for the reservation waitlist, notifications, problem reservations, and server sections. The list view allows you to see more parties at a time to better manage your waitlist and your reservations. The timeline helps to identify reservation gaps, resolve conflicts, and helps to highlight where you can squeeze in another party or two. The shift overview screen provides information about your shifts, like cover count, covers by time, covers by source, and parties by party size. You also have access to shift notes. These could be reservation specific, like seating preferences, or notes from your manager, like a reminder about what side work needs to be done, or what menu items are 86'd. The guestbook contains all of your recorded guest info, like contact information, as well as food and seating preferences. In server sections, you can modify what tables your servers are assigned to, as well as add another server for future shifts. As mentioned before, you also have access to adjusting server sections from the floor plan. Settings enables you to change your settings and preferences for the OpenTable app. This includes general app settings like enabling light mode or always display server sections on the floor plan. You can also modify user action logging, such as requiring usernames when a reservation date and time has changed. You can add users under user management, as well as adjust your chip printer settings or your notification settings. Help and feedback links to resources from OpenTable. You can also submit feedback directly to OpenTable from here as well. Sign out will log you out of OpenTable, which otherwise won't occur, even if you exit the app.